Francois gets New Zealand's World Cup campaign away against Barbados. Straight away, good pressure from the Bajans.
Where you are, wait.
Kizzy Marvel, that wing defence.
Contact.
Experienced player. This is her fourth World Cup. Not falling for Tutaia. Nez gets her World Cup underway. So much interest in her, pressure on her too.
Good to see that first shot go in. She's often so hesitant at the start of matches, Bailey Mez. Seeing the Silver Ferns already just putting on that zone defence. And the Beijers just struggling to find space, but what a beautiful ball.
Well, take that, threading the needle straight to Wharton.
Latonia Blackman not at all intimidated by her opposition.
Mez not wanting to shoot.
Barney to contact, wing defender.
Cheeky from Maria Tutaia. She had a smile on her face as she turned.
Barney to contact. Barbados.
Oh, beautiful. Well, she did her best, Rhiann Niles, but it was a fairly demanding centre pass. She's the captain of this Bajan team.
Barney to obstruction wing. Barney to offside. Barney to contact, wing defender. Contact, goalkeeper.
Oh, unlucky, Bruce. With me. She's really quite a commanding presence in that circle.
Turn around, keeper.
Just a footwork let her down a little bit then. And that is a challenge for Barbados. Get their feet moving. If they want to have a go at these balls, they're going to get around and move around the Silver Ferns' bodies.
Well, that's a pretty good start for Mez.
Mounted construction, goal defence.
She's another experienced campaigner for this Barbados side. Her fourth World Cup as well. They've had quite a few changes in this Bajan side. Some of the old names have gone. And they've brought in a bit of youth.
Well, if you just look at that front line, they are just really young. 19, Shanika Walken, the goal shooter.
Offside.
But she looks really composed early.
Yeah, with me, inside. Come around, with me.
Oh, good contest then from Bruce. It's a couple of little wins she's had.
She's totally unintimidated by a black dress. There she goes again. Oh, brilliant. Blackman.
Oh, offside.
No, she's enjoying herself.
Contact.
In the meantime, New Zealand push out to 5-2. Early stages. Oh, way too much as that goes out the back. Of course, we've talked about that conundrum for New Zealand around the midcourt. Also a bit of a conundrum at the defensive end for different reason. I mean, do you play Debrain, Kolpua, Grant, Debrain, Grant, Kolpua?
I reckon in these early games, you've got to play Casey Kolpua simply because she's still in the process of getting a game feet back and she needs to get a timing right. One of the key elements of her game is having a good crack out at those intercepts outside the circle. That takes time to get back.
This is good for Mez's confidence.
Bunny's breaking attack.
Breaking, gold attack. New Zealand.
Five from five, Bailey Mez.
Shannon Francois, that's a nice feed. Grandmother Noel will like that. She's in the crowd here in Sydney, along with a fair swag of the Rasmussen clan. And apparently more family on the bus.
Good to see Bailey Mez just be prepared to turn and go straight to the ring. The first few minutes of the game, she wanted to pass the ball around. So crucial that she builds a confidence by facing the ring early.
Yes, I should say, very easy, isn't it, for teams like New Zealand? Well, for New Zealand, perhaps the Pacific teams, to get family and supporters across to Sydney. Not so easy for the likes of Barbados. It's a long way and an expensive way.
The win for Bruce, yep. Oh, Langman.
Contact wing defender.
Got a good example then, or a good sight of just how quick she is off the mark. Just a couple of times, this Bajan team and some of the players have had the opportunity to win back some crummy ball and control possession, but just haven't been able to do it.
Contact wing advantage offside.
And it's just because the support isn't there.
Contact defender.
Unable to bring it in.
And Nikita Piggott, the smallest player in that circle. When a timing was perfect and a placement or positioning was perfect, just couldn't control it. Oh, good win. And a win back from Grace Rasmussen.
Oh, today, barely in court, but contact the call.
So Latonia Blackman just proving that she's going to be a handful defensively around the edge of the circle. The Ferns have to put it away from her long arms.
New Zealand.
And we move through to double figures. There's Anna Shepherd.
Construction defender.
She's got some real experience behind her as a coach, Shepherd. She coached Barbados 87-99 World Cup. About three, I think, Commonwealth Games.
Contact.
Former
wing
player
defense.
As well.
Contact. Vantage obstruction, centre. Contact,
got
shooter, penalty.
Long time between drinks for Barbados.
Shonika Wharton just proving a little bit expensive at the moment.
Contact, goalkeeper.
A couple of times she's giving the ball away, just sitting at one from two.
Titi needed that. She's sitting on four from seven at the moment. She's never super high in the percentage, really, is she? So many of her shots are from way out.
No, but if New Zealand are going to win this World Cup, she needs to be sitting at least 80%.
Now, great lean from Grant, but the shot is even better. Number three for Barbados.
Really interesting to hear Norma Plummer speaking about the Silver Fern shooting circle. Another win for Bruce. She's been handy in that goalkeeper position for Barbados. Norma Plummer, very vocal, as are the crowd. What a beautiful long pass.
Well, Barbados show New Zealand about straight-line play, straight down the middle of the court.
Often when you're playing against a zone defence, just for a split second, that middle will open up, but it just needs the pass to be perfect and low, and Barbados have done it a couple of times and found really good space.
For Barbados.
Watch Bruce there. Really good contest for the ball. Got her feet moving, and that was the difference.
He's perhaps a little too relaxed. And again, Barbados defence disrupting play.
Lovely sharp passing there between the Silver Ferns front line.
Oh,
That's what I'm talking about with Casey Kōpua. She's caused a turnover, but she saw that intercept just a little too late, half a second too late. Did a good job to get out there and contest it, but the Casey Kōpua of 18 months ago would have eaten that up. So that's why New Zealand must have her on the court, just to get her timing back.
Great contest between Marvel and Rasmussen.
Hold goal, defender advantage, keeper contact. Where you are. Advantage. Possession shooter, possession. New Zealand.
4.5 minutes remaining in the first quarter. 13-5, New Zealand over Barbados.
Lovely little look away pass there from Grace Rasmussen. Bruce nearly read it.
Oh, it looked as though it was going to fall nicely.
Second time that Nikita Piggott's just pushed through on the centre pass and she's just got caught then. Again, it's the footwork that's let her down. Really just wanted to push through with the shoulders and didn't use her feet to create some space.
Tuta here taking her time, making sure of it. 10 goal margin, 16-6.
In contact center.
Hey, she's had such a roller coaster of a career, really. Into the Silver Ferns as a surprise inclusion at wing attack a number of years ago. Had a pretty horrendous time of it, as I remember. But she has shown tremendous tenacity, really.
She certainly has, after that horrific knee injury she suffered in 2013, to come back, and she's lost none of her athleticism, and that's a challenge when you do your knee, is to not lose that vertical jump and display there. It's pretty good.
Yeah, Shanette Bruce had no answer for that move. It's more clinical from New Zealand.
I reckon they'll be happy with this opening, but there's a couple of minutes in the middle of this quarter that I think they'll be disappointed in the fact that they just allowed themselves to get a little bit sloppy, didn't execute the pass. And that's another good example. Blackman has been so good around the edge of the circle. She's got her hands into a couple. And I reckon that's where the Silver Ferns coaching staff will direct their attention to at this quarter time break. Beautiful tip there from Tutoye.
The thing I like about Latonia Blackman is the positions she plays: centre, goal defence, and goal attack. Not the most usual.
Bit of everything.
Look out for her anywhere.
I got asked this morning on radio in Sydney about what the position that you play says about your personality, but if you're Latonia Blackman, she's a bit of everything.
Yes, there's a couple of players here. I can't just think who it is. They've put down five positions. The only place they don't play is in the shooting circle.
You wouldn't want to be a shooter, would you, Jen?
No.
Maybe the lip gloss ran out.
Just over 30 seconds remaining. 20 goals to 7.
Great defensive pressure here from the Ferns. Trying to force Barbados into an error, and there it is.
Francois waits.
Yeah, lovely delivery from Francois.
That's that rebound we talk about.
New Zealand.
Incredible standing jump of Bailey Mears. And here's the ball. The result of all that defensive pressure earlier. And that's held ball, and then the next whistle, the end of the quarter.
And that's quarter time.
Jean Francois turns around and says, yes, that is the first 15 minutes. So certainly not perfect from New Zealand, and Barbados making them work for it. New Zealand lead 21-7. So not totally clinical from New Zealand, and Barbados certainly showing that they've got some young players, particularly in that shooting circle, that are going to make a few teams think about what they're doing.
Yeah, there are a couple of early nerves from Shanika Wharton, but when she settled down, she actually really started to come into the game, shot 5 from 6 in that quarter. Really impressive from her, and that defensive pressure from Barbados, they got their hands to some really nice balls.
Supporters ranging here, I'm so proud to be an ambassador for Rebel.
So let's have a look at the numbers now. Look at the difference in the number of attempts.
But then just have a look down that goal percentage. New Zealand sitting on 75%, Barbados 88%. So Barbados aren't getting the attempts, but they're making the most of what they're getting. For the Ferns, I want to just lift that percentage up. You really can't, as I said, win a World Cup sitting with your goal shooting sitting in the 70s. You've got to be up in the 80s, high 80s, low 90s. Just take a look at the highlights from the first quarter, and that's that thread the needle there. Just beautiful play between Shanika Wharton and Sabrina Smith, and a couple of times the Bajans were able just to find that back space. Speaking of back space, Maria Tutoye finding plenty of it using just nice little sharp passes. The Ferns, when they were on the run and on the move, they started to find some really nice space through that quarter, but a couple of times just started, they had a few little lapses in that opening 15 minutes, and that's where they want to pick things up. It's pretty hard when you're sort of leading a quarter by 14 goals to, I guess, beat yourself up too badly, but every time the Ferns step out on court, they'll be looking for the improvements, and you know, there's some really nice stuff happening for them out there.
Barbados ranked number 9 in the world at the moment. And so tough really for some of these teams in Sydney to get up and improve that ranking the way the draw goes, but they'll be doing their best. The New Zealanders getting into the rhythm of the arena. Why the red wigs, I don't know.
Maybe so they get on television.
It's that simple.
So for this Barbados team, I guess they would have certain goals that they want to achieve. When you're going into a team ranked that much higher than you, you know you're going to have to be spot on with your goal setting.
It's 21-7 as the Silver Ferns return to the court for this second quarter in this Pool A match against Barbados. There is Latonia Blackman keen to get on with things. Centre for Barbados, the linchpin. Barbados away. 21-7 in New Zealand's favour.
Contact centre. That's it.
Langman remaining in that wing defence bib. I should mention it's Langman's 120th test. There's the big block from Kaupua.
Not only her 120th test, it's consecutive. That is just phenomenal.
Extraordinary. And here we go, Barbados again. Can Smith did her best. Entertaining game.
Vantage contact. Wing it.
And this is what I like about World Cups. You know, you get teams that don't necessarily see that much of each other, and you get the different styles, and when they all collide, it's usually pretty good to watch. A big chase from Sabrina Smith.
She did really well to keep that ball in play, but Katrina Grant there to mop up.
Vantage contact, wing attack.
Little falcon there from Bailey Mez. Probably give her teammates a bit of a giggle at the end of the game.
Wing obstruction.
What's been really impressive about Shanika Wharton, a goal shooter for Barbados, she stands at 6'2", but she's really quite mobile. She hasn't really played a holding game. And I reckon that's caught Casey Kukua by surprise a little bit.
Tutia over the top. Niles goes sideways.
goal defender contact with the goal defence. Contact, keeper.
Couture was onto it. Contacted as she did so. Barbados on the board in the second quarter. Rasmussen just seems to float through the air sometimes.
She does, and she's like that when she's got the ball in hand. The ball seems to float a bit out of her hand. Her pass comes from her forearm, so she's so incredibly strong to be able to do that. Flick of the wrist and it's a bullet. Most of us mere mortals have to wind the arm up to get that speed going in our pass, but she's amazing.
Again, New Zealand thwarted.
Barney's extraction, goal attack. Barney's contact, centre end obstruction. Centre obstruction.
Beautiful patient play then from Barbados in the build-up. Not tempted to go long and put the ball in the air, which is what the Ferns want them to do. Oh,
throw it.
Put out of court.
Yeah, it was a bigger bounce than I think Wharton expected. It went higher.
It was a lovely build-up, though. It deserved to be finished.
Vantage contact, wing defence.
Bruce certainly making Mez work for every little thing.
She is, and one thing that I reckon the Diamonds and England will look at from this is that when Mez has been challenged a few times in this game, just hasn't quite got the hands around the ball to pull them in. So they'll watch that and know that if you just keep challenging, you may very well come up with a pill. Oh, smart play from Piggott. Saw that Wharton was double defended. That gave her the whole circle free for a cut and drive.
And finishes it itself as well. Had a stint in the English Super League a few years ago. Nikita Piggott went up to Loughborough. Barbados being held up on the transverse.
Defender. Goal defender obstruction. Obstruction, both out.
Barbados has certainly managed to put a break on the New Zealand scoring.
5 minutes into the second quarter and Barbados lead this quarter 4-2. They'll put it in the scrapbook if they come away with a win here in this quarter.
Up there with that half.
Well, and that's what I was talking about earlier, in that you do set your goals when you're playing against a much higher ranked team, and there's things that you want to achieve, and I'm sure one of those things would have been to win a quarter, maybe win a half.
That was a nice little hand from Shannon Francois. In the circle.
And it's those little goals that make you push through. Even if you don't win the game, there's things you want to achieve as a team.
I suppose conversely, that works the other way, doesn't it? If you're playing a team that you think is, you know, of less experience than yourself, you're setting different goals, aren't you?
Absolutely. And you don't want to let yourself start to flag or get sloppy simply because you've got a pretty good lead on the scoreboard. That's a challenge for the Ferns. They opened up with a blistering first quarter, 21-7. Now they've got to make sure they keep their heads in it and keep pushing through.
That was an impressive display along those lines earlier today. Jamaica over Samoa, they were in that position. Never really let up. They got something like 90 goals. They're here to play, Jamaica.
And, you know, when you're in the Diamonds team, the Jamaica always score a lot in World Cup in the opening games, and people start to think, oh, you know, why aren't the Diamonds scoring as many? Why can't Australia score as many goals as that? You start to get a bit anxious after a while. Why aren't we scoring that many goals? certainly helps when your goal shooter's 6 foot seven.
Yes, you'd have to say, though, in the end, you haven't done too badly.
No, it's been okay, but it is funny. You do get quite anxious just looking at stats early in the tournament. And
advantage instruction.
You sort of need to take a deep breath and just do only control what you can control. World Cups do funny things to your brain, Jen.
Well, New Zealand starting to get a wriggle on. Just about halfway through the second quarter.
Breaking goal attack.
Help ball.
Oh, Bruce. No, it wasn't Bruce. It was Niles that read it beautifully. Didn't quite recover it quickly enough, though. And Tutaiero by herself.
Yeah, that was a lovely quick throw, and I think from Rasmus and Niles still had it back to the ball, wandering back. Netball's equivalent of the quick line out.
Contact.
Good defensive pressure from the Ferns. And it reached the reward they were after.
New Zealand.
That's the beauty of that zone style defence that the Ferns are so good at. They either pull off a magnificent screaming intercept across the court, or they do force teams into errors.
Advantage contact centre.
Beautiful vision there from Shannon Francois. Interesting to see her in the midcourt, Jen. I quite like her athleticism in that position. She brings something quite different to Laura Langman. Laura Langman has a real tendency to dominate the space and dominate, I guess, that middle corridor. Francois, you can see her. She's starting to just try and make space for Grace Rasmussen, trying to pull out of things and allow Rasmussen and Tutaiya to have the lead. For mine, that's a sign of a pretty good centre court player.
Now, here's something for you all to think about. During the Netball World Cup, ANZ Netball Nations inviting fans to show their support for their nation and get their game face on. So you simply upload a photo of yourself in your nation's colours and include the hashtag NWCNation. 10 daily prizes to be won. And I tell you what, they're good. They include 2 tickets to the Netball World Cup gold medal match on day 10, and that includes flights and accommodation. So head to netballnation.com/NWC and you'll get all the details. So get into it. Get behind your nation today.
Is that Sharon McMahon?
I think it is. Or else it's a twin sister.
Oh, God, don't tell me there's 2 of them.
Anna Shepherd having a few things to say there. 20 goal margin now for the Ferns, 31-11. Roughly 6 minutes left in the second quarter.
Lots of positive talk in that Barbados huddle then. I like it when I hear a coach just giving her players really specific things to focus on. Oh, beautiful work, Laura Langman. Talking about liking Francois in that centre position, I really like Laura Langman in at wing defence.
And that's the issue too, it's always one of the issues anyway. I know Waitomono, when Francois came onto the scene, I remember her saying she was delighted she'd finally found somebody who was fast enough to keep up with Langman.
Well, Laura Langman's just an extraordinary athlete.
Yes, there are people who would like Langman in centre and wing defence.
None of those are Australian, I can guarantee you. I just think she reads the game really well in wing defence and has a really great impact bringing the ball down court. The other wing defence option for the Ferns, obviously, or one of the other options, is Kayla Cullen. I'm looking forward to seeing if she gets a run in the second half of this game.
I would bet your bottom dollar that she will. She's been in good touch, Kayla Cullen. She's had, ever since that really, well, all ACLs are bad. You know, just on the eve of
no
the Youth
Cup.
There's
no such thing as a good ACL.
Oh, I had a pretty good ACL. But, and it was a long road back for Cullen, but in the last few tests, towards the end of the ANZ, really starting to show some speed.
Yeah, really interesting that it took her a long time just to get to the point where she was running, just, you know, watching on social media her progress. It was painfully slow. And she had a couple of really great games in the ANZ Championships this year where she was able just to run into some form and find the ball, and that's her strength.
I think at her peak, Cullen reminds me, or I always describe her as almost Corletto-esque.
Yeah, really great ball getters, and the thing with Julie Corletto that Kayla Cullen has is that closing speed onto the intercept. Out of play, goal. You can often see attacking players go, where does she come from?
New Zealand.
So 9 from 11 for Shanika Wharton.
Oh, long ball, Rasmussen. Tutahia probably should have taken care of that one herself. And she does this time.
That's what she does best, isn't it?
Just 11 from 14 in this half for Tutahia.
I do get the feeling that Maria Tutahia is still finding her way within this shooting circle.
Oh, and away she comes. She's found a way this time.
Vantage contact, wing defense.
What's that ball speed from Grace Rasmussen?
I think that was a planned move from there. She hit the rim so that she could come and
get the rebound.
By her side, please, player.
Oh, Bruce. Contact. Whack on the back of the head. You're right, though, about Tutahia. So many years of either knowing that Irene van Dijk was behind you or Catherine Latu. Now they're gone, both of them. And there's a different style going. That looked awkward for Bruce.
Certainly did. Just interesting to read an interview with Maria Tutahia in the New Zealand press where she felt that it was just taking a bit of time to find her comfort level. And she felt that in previous years she'd just been allowed to float into the circle, or able to float into the circle and do what she does, whereas now she really needs to be part of setting up play and setting up that goal shooter position because they need to move the ball so much more. Good take there from Piggott. She knew exactly where the line was, but it wasn't a great delivery. Oh!
Offside. Bring half inside, ladies. Inside.
Beautiful contest, and yeah, from Marvel. It's a top name.
Well, yes.
For a wing defender.
Up and over the back, Bailey Mears.
So Bailey Mears sitting at 24 from 31. She's just missed a couple. And we saw in the earlier play where she was just all over that rebound. Just got blocked out then a little bit, and that's going to be the issue for her. Should she play against Australia on Sunday?
Contact, goal defender.
That's what they're good at defensively, is blocking out that rebounding position.
Isn't that something to look forward to? The way the draw is in this particular World Cup, the big guns meeting early. England, Jamaica, New Zealand, Australia. With the prospect that, you know, they're all going to have to play again later. Tutahia. Just takes out the camera. You can hear the zone call, all middle.
Vantage contact, goal shooter.
Barbados, though, undeterred.
Wing defender. Obstruction.
Oh, beautiful work there from Casey Kaupua, but got the obstruction call. The jump on the shot, the timing was perfect.
Not the intended target, but it really doesn't matter. The idea was right. It is half time in this match between New Zealand and Barbados. 15-6, that's quarter to New Zealand. But overall, the halftime score at the break, New Zealand 36, Barbados 13.
Get into netball with Alexander Netsevka and Sporting Schools. Netball Australia has partnered with the Australian Government's $100 million Sporting Schools program to get Australia's kids active, engaged, and having fun. There is no such thing as too much netball. Thanks to Telstra, you can get more of what you love with the Netball Live app. Download today. Chemist Warehouse loves to celebrate a happy and healthy lifestyle. So, this Netball World Cup, remember to get well, stay well, live well, and look fabulous every day with Chemist Warehouse, the house of wellness. Gilead is proud to be the official and exclusive ball supplier to the International Netball Federation. Gilbert is a truly global netball brand, supporting the netball family by providing products that ensure all users feel confident, look good, and perform at every level to achieve their goals.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is, of course, the Netball World Cup, first time in 24 years it has been in Australia. And with thanks to ANZ and ANZ's Netball Nation, they have been asking fans to get their game face on. We've got some prizes to give away. It's great to have so many wonderful people here in the crowd. And now we would like to see who is the biggest supporter. And if our camera finds you, not only will you win a wonderful prize with thanks to ANZ, but you'll be chatting to international superstar Temapara Bailey, who has joined us here for the course of the World Cup. Bit of a legend, she's a bit of a big thing in these parts. Temapara, where are you? Where is our wonderful, wonderful MC in the crowd? And who is going to win the ANZ Get Your Game Face On prize? Where are you?
Not far away from the second half at the moment. It is New Zealand 36-13 over Barbados.
They've just started to creep up that goal percentage to 78%. Four intercepts per team, and it's been a pretty good defensive game. The Ferns have started to build some really nice pressure through their zone defence. Their timing is yet to come, though, in terms of getting out and having a crack at the ball. That's been made difficult by the fact that the Barbados team are playing a really patient sort of game. And they're playing a really short, sharp game. They're really not letting that ball go long, which is what Casey Kapua would want and what Katrina Grant will be looking for. So they'll be hoping they can force them into some longer, more riskier passes in this second half. For the Ferns, they had a few lapses again in terms of their ball handling in that second quarter. But when they got it right, it looked superb. And especially when they were able to find Bailey Mez on the move and put a nice high ball into her. She really got to show what she's capable of in terms of her athleticism. In terms of her shooting, she had a couple of little lapses in that second quarter, was able to gather a few rebounds, but she really does need to finish on that first shot when she can.
There's two pretty even quarters for Barbados. Seven goals in the first, six in the second. But not so much for New Zealand, 21, and then just 15 goals in that second quarter.
And it was a good defensive effort from Barbados. They started to really get their hands in and get around the edges of the circle, and that's where they were able to pull back some possession.
Well, it'll be interesting to see what sort of changes both sides make. I can tell you for New Zealand, as two other shooters are warming up, and of course the same for Barbados. I guess so important on this day one. It's the first game for all these teams. You want to get everyone out there, don't you?
You do, because the nerves are killing you as a player. You've spent so many months preparing and thinking about it. You want to make, you'd really work hard to make sure that you actually get here in one piece. You want to get out now and play.
So the second half, not far away. Stand by. New Zealand 36, Barbados 13.
And please do not take a bag from any other seat. Please do not swap your bags with anyone else. Each section has different coloured props in them. We will show you what to do with your props during the opening ceremony pre-show at 6:40 p.m. Thank you.
Half time in this Pool A clash between New Zealand and Barbados. New Zealand firmly in control, 36-13. And at the moment, New Zealand is having a little run amongst themselves out on court while Barbados prepare themselves for the second half. New Zealand, well, they wouldn't have been totally happy with that first half at all. Reasonable first quarter, not so good on the second.
Now, defensively, I think they were pretty consistent from quarter to quarter. It was just maintaining control of the ball, and if just towards the end of that second quarter they started to let some long passes go. I'm a little bit concerned about the form, to be honest, of Maria Tuitaia, and I think that's something that will really come into play over the next 2 days. Is she the Silver Ferns' number one goal attack at the moment?
Well, it's a point of debate. Jodie Brown has certainly been in very good form. They're totally different players, aren't Brown a real playmaker?
She is, whereas Maria Tuitaia really comes into the circle and demands the ball and is happy to turn and shoot. The shooter almost takes second, plays second fiddle to her, whereas Jodie Brown is willing to set up her shooting partner and will move the ball around really well. And she's a bit of a hustler. She'll, you know, she'll take on the body.
Certainly looks like New Zealand winning the changes. Phoenix Karaka with the goalkeeper bib on. Langman to centre. Oh, So I would think all change on the Silver Fern bench. Oh, and they're grooving in the stands. What the World Cup's all about, isn't it? I know people who just save on a four-yearly cycle to move from one cup to the next.
Yeah, and there's people here who are out here every day for 12 hours. Caught up with Irene van Dyke yesterday, and she's hosting a group that are here for 12 hours every day for 10 days.
She'll be in her element. Second half away. Barbados in possession. Rasmussen on the hustle. Blackman hits the deck. So it doesn't look like any changes for Barbados, but there are a raft of them for New Zealand. There's three of them right there. Kayla Cullen at wing defence, Karaka, as I mentioned, at goalkeep, and Leona De Bruyne at goal defence.
Changes down this end, Jodie Brown on at goal attack. And Malia Pasika on at goal shooter. Big moment for her, born in Auckland, but spent 10 years living in Sydney. So a huge moment for her, really exciting to see her out there. Her family will be along to watch her later in the week.
So in fact, the only Silver Ferns on the court now who were in the first half, Langman and Rasmussen.
Has been one change to the Barbados team. Goal defence, Rhianne Niles has come off, Shanice Rock has come on. Another young Bayesian player, just 22 years of age, standing at 5'11", so she faces a pretty big ask against the incredibly experienced Jodie Brown.
Crafty Brown. She's a great story, Jodie Brown, really. Had a career and then went away from the international game for, I think, five years. Had a couple of children and came back.
Yeah, she was out for 5 years. Stepped away in 2007, back in 2012.
Paseka on the board. She's an exciting player, Malia Paseka. New Zealand would like to thank Sydney and Australia.
Well, I'd like to say she was stolen, but she really always had dreams of playing for the Silver Ferns. Yeah, good defensive effort there from the Ferns. Forcing the hill ball. Yeah, good rebound from Bruce. She's been solid in that circle for Barbados. Samantha Brown is on a wing attack. Also for Barbados. She replaces Sabrina Smith, who I thought had a pretty good opening half.
It's the story I love about Sam Brown is when she was first on the scene, she was playing international netball with her mother.
Isn't that great, lovely? Jackie Brown, one of the greats of the Barbados team. Speaking of great, what a brilliant long pass.
That's how it started with Karaka.
I reckon Phoenix Karaka is an incredibly exciting talent for the Ferns. Gee, she reads the ball well and she's committed to it. Put a body on the line to get it, and her timing then, just exquisite.
And I think, Liz, that's what's perhaps injected a little bit of hope into what was for a little while a fairly gloomy netball horizon, really, in New Zealand. They had not the greatest season by any stretch last year, the Silver Ferns, but there's this youth coming through. These young players, many of them who went to Glasgow 2013 with the Youth Cup, won it in an upset, really, from Australia in the final. Time to see how they deliver on the big stage.
Yeah, and you do get the sense that a lot of these young players are going to be around for the Silver Ferns for a long time. I've really got my doubts as to whether they'll be standing up for the Ferns come finals time, but I think this experience will do them the world of good in 10 years' time. Gee, it's ominous.
Still, the goal's not falling. Here come Barbados.
Contact, wing attack.
Rasmussen called. Maria Miles now at wing defence.
Vantage contact.
Oh, Karaka again. Just prepared to have a go at it. Neatly done, but I think she just went off. No, perhaps contacted as she did so.
Barbados.
Yeah, Bruce has been strong in that rebounding position. Doesn't do a lot of preparatory work to hold out the space, but she's got a lovely vertical jump, and that's what's allowed her to get her hands on the ball.
We used to do a folk dance a bit like that. I think it's primary school.
Contact centre.
Wharton doing a lot of work in that circle. And it's worked for her. Test for De Bruyne. Karaka way out of the circle.
Instruction. Wing defence both out. One step back, players.
World Cup number 5 for Liana De Bruyne. Select group. Oh, beautifully patient. Yeah, deserved applause. Nice save, Jodie Brown.
Well, here's a little stat for you, Jen, as the ball goes up to the Barbados shooting end. The Barbados Bayesian shooting pair of Shanika Thomas and Shanika Thomas and Shanika Wharton together are aged 35. They're 17 and 18 apiece, which makes their combined age younger than Liana De Bruyne at 38.
I'm sure she'll feel really good about that.
It's extraordinary. It is unbelievable. And Liana De Bruyne is just a phenomenal athlete. She has improved again this year. She's really worked her way into that goal defence position. She's more used to that goalkeeper position. So really to be dominating against such a young shooting circle speaks volumes about her. But she may not want to be reminded of it.
Great contesting again from Bruce. Timing was perfect.
Use the feet to get around in front of Pasika.
Pretty flat third quarter so far from New Zealand.
Contact shooter.
Seven, 4 the margin at the moment. Oh, in fact, 7-6. My maths are sadly lacking.
Advantage obstruction, goalkeeper, advantage offside, centre.
Oh, De Bruyne copped a big shove then from Thomas.
Contact. Hold, please.
She's just wondering if the floor is a bit damp. Could do with a mop, and here it comes. So 6.5 minutes remaining in the third. 43-19. You'd think those that itch, all that tinsel under that hat.
A good start to this third quarter from Barbados. They've made some changes across that transverse line. New goal attack and a new wing attack in for this quarter. And they're getting a lot better penetration into the front line.
There's Kayla Cullen, that's that speed.
Yeah. That's probably the play of the match so far from New Zealand. If you watch Cullen there, there's a closing speed, and the way they moved the ball down the court then, there was a good bit of spark. And they've backed it up again with another nice build-up.
And that might just be the spark that they need in this third quarter. As I say, they've gone a bit flat. But they've really been made to go flat because this Barbados side isn't letting them do much more.
Yeah, a really good point, Jen. You've got to give them credit. They've mixed it up in attack. They've been incredibly patient in their build-up. They haven't put in long balls for the Silver Ferns to pick up as Orton goes down.
Now that looks so painful. Oh, the 19-year-old. What's she grabbing hold of? Is it the back of her leg? The calf, but it looked so awkward. She was playing well.
She was, sitting at 14 from 16, a couple of goal assists and a rebound to her name. And it was...
I wonder if that was a knee.
Well, don't say that.
I know I shouldn't.
You take that back, Jenny.
Ankle.
Yep, we'll take ankle every day of the week. That can be fixed. So.
Still not a good sight, though. Shanika Wharton, she's been strong under the hoop for Barbados, and she looks unhappy, doesn't she?
She certainly does. Sometimes, I certainly hope this is the case for her today, you do your ankle and it rolls and you feel like your foot's fallen off, but with a couple of minutes and a bit of ice, it tends to settle down. And I think it'd be a shame if they lost her under the post. She's been a really good target, but what's been impressive about what she's been doing is the movement that she's brought to this game.
They've certainly got options, though. They have Faye Seeley, another shooter in the squad. They can move Pickett back. She's used to playing goal shoot. Just over 5 minutes remaining in this third quarter. Yes, the fib is being ripped off. Now that's a very good reception for Wharton. She's contributed to this game.
New Zealand.
Meanwhile, New Zealand goes about its business. 46-20.
Barbados.
Oh, two quick goals makes that 47.
So how does this Barbados front line respond? Thomas and Piggott in there. So two small players.
Shaniqua Thomas now at goal attack. And Piggott at the back. We were talking about how Wharton was young. Well, Shaniqua Thomas is even younger. She's 17. In fact, I'm pretty sure she's the youngest player in the tournament. So what a moment.
Throwing Barbados.
Jodie Brown out of court and she tapped that ball. Bruce acknowledges the error. Talk about these young players and the moment in a World Cup, and I tell you what, even this arena, 17,000, it is massive. And I can't imagine that many of the younger players would have played anything like this.
No, well, it was interesting speaking to Anna Shepherd, the Barbados coach, yesterday. She was really generous with her time and told us a bit about their build-up. And one of the things we asked her about was what she thought about this stadium when they walked in. And she said they were simply blown away because Barbados haven't been able to prepare on a wooden surface in their lead-up. So they've done all their training on asphalt and some of it on sand. So to walk in here and have not only a magnificent surface, but a 17,000 seat stadium, which I understand is already sold out for 4 days of this tournament. So 4 days, there's going to be world records broken, which is just phenomenal for a netball crowd. But, yeah, the Bajans were pretty impressed when they walked in.
It's a timely reminder, though, isn't it, that the things that these countries endure, really, to get here. I mean, perhaps the likes of New Zealand, Australia, England, Jamaica, or not so much Jamaica, that was a challenge for them too. But the resources that some of these, perhaps the African countries, that they simply don't have, that we take for granted.
Well, you contrast the Australian build-up with, say, the Ugandan build-up, and, you know, the Diamonds have had, you know, they're paid pretty well, they're all professional, semi-professional netballers, the top players, Laura Geitz, players like that, have got really good commercial deals, they've got the luxury of being able to be full-time athletes, whereas the Ugandans raise money to get here by washing cars. So, you know, it's extraordinary, and that's why I love the World Cup, because you see athletes who don't have that support being able to take on athletes who do have that support, and sometimes they beat them, which is great to see. And it doesn't have to be beating them in a game, it can just be beating them in a one-on-one contest, and that's why the World Cup's so great.
Talking about one-on-one contest, De Bruin absolutely stuck one-on-one to young Thomas.
Oh, how did that pass get through? Extraordinary from Brown.
And she scores it. Shaniqua Thomas.
Oh, those passes into Pasika are starting to stick. Of course, Rasmussen and Pasika playing the same club team in the Trans-Tasman tournament. Just a sneaky little pass there between Brown and Thomas.
Back Barbados go, rebuild.
And it's a good ploy, it's worked for them all game, going back to go forward. Not only do they go backwards, but they go cross-court, and that just sets up some other avenues down the court for them.
That's the style of Pasika that has really created her so many fans. And that's not bad from Rasmussen either.
12 from 15 from Pasika. Making her World Cup debut.
I'll take a bow, De Bruin.
New Zealand wing area.
In the end, so easy.
Contact shooter.
Oh, just a tangle of feet.
Bunny's contact shooter.
So better in the latter stages of that third quarter, New Zealand. But Barbados still fighting hard. At the end of the third quarter, it is New Zealand leading 53-24.
Equaling the record for the most Netball World Cups. This is the fifth Netball World Cup record held by New Zealand.
Perhaps a bit of a shaky start to that third quarter for New Zealand. They came right a little bit. A lot of new combinations, of course.
And sometimes it takes a while to bed in those combinations. A few World Cup debutants on court for the Silver Ferns, Kayla Cullen, Malia Pasika. And sometimes those nerves do affect what you're doing.
Not too bad, a quarter for Barbados, their highest scoring, 11 goals.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive. For New Zealand, the intercepts went up in that quarter. So five intercepts in that third quarter for the Silver Ferns, which brings them to 9 for the game. So both the defenders that they brought on then in De Bruin and Karaka are both really great ball getters. They both picked up 2 intercepts apiece. But what they didn't do was really shut down the avenue to goal. And the Barbados team did a really good job scoring 11 goals. Shaniqua Thomas came on, scored 4 from 5. And Wharton, unfortunately, went to the bench, but Nikita Piggott replaced her at goal shooter and was able just to continue that run going. So really the Bajan team did well, only went down by 6 goals in that quarter. And for the Silver Ferns, it was a bit of a sloppy opening part of the quarter. Then they got into it. One of the things that they started to do well was just release the ball, take a few risks. The combination between Rasmussen and Pasika really came to the fore. So we saw them running the ball down court really nicely. Laura Langman in centre contributed to that. She's a real ball carrier through the court for the Ferns. Just to finish sometimes didn't quite happen. Jodie Brown there, finishing off there. 5 from 7 for her for the quarter. Malia Paseka, 12 from 16. So a pretty good opening gambit for some new Silver Ferns players.
There's Waimaramo Tomonu and, of course, assistant Vicky Wilson. Funny to think, isn't it, that when Waitomonu was captaining the Silver Ferns here in Sydney in 1991, it was Vicky Wilson who was playing a very large part in the demise of the Silver Ferns in the final by just one goal. How times change. So we await the fourth and final quarter. 53-24 New Zealand lead as things stand. Ferns head on out. Tomonu sticking with the same 7 as she had in the third.
Interesting to hear Waitomonu talk about the fact that she wanted her team to take risks through the path of this tournament. She knows that they're an unknown quantity for their opposition. And I just felt in the second half of that third quarter, they did start to take those risks. They started to move the ball around and they got the ball speed going. That's going to be hard to combat.
Nice tip there from Rock, who's now gone back to goal defence. Facey on at goal shoot. Just put a little bit of height into that Bajan circle.
With the goal defender.
Well, our media guide says that Facey is 180 centimetres. I reckon she's a little bit taller than that. I think she's foxy.
Rebound to Brain. Oh, the hang in the air from Langman. Beautifully finished by Paseka. Not too much on that. The Silver Ferns will be pleased. Our ball. Always pretty rewarding.
So Cherise Seal on a wing attack for Barbados. Just another change made for them through their midcourt.
So relaxed by Rasmussen. Beautifully finished. I wonder if this is where fitness, that sort of thing, will play a factor in this fourth quarter.
Well, that has to really play a factor. Barbados have made plenty of changes.
Good rebound for Bruce.
So they should have the benefit of some fresh legs, as do the Ferns. But as this game goes on, you would expect for the Ferns to really start to come into their own.
Nice shot from Faye Seeley.
She's quite a flat release for a tall player. She can probably afford to do that.
DeBrain got the tip. They had no idea where it was.
Yeah, good scramble there from Rasmussen. And you can just see at the moment it's a 3-on-2 as the ball flies down the court. And that is fitness. Just the ability of the Barbados players just to recover. And that's something that is a really good indicator of fitness.
Vantage contact with defence. Vantage deliberate obstruction.
It was unfortunate for Paseka, got tangled on the feet of Bruce. You could also call that good defence, Barbados. the wall from New Zealand.
Advantage obstruction.
Quickly onto the loose ball, Barbados.
That beautiful speed through court of Laura Langman is great, but sometimes you want her to put the brakes on. Just really had nowhere to go to. And I reckon that's a bit of a hangover, Jen, of having that tall shooter available. You know, Laura Langman could always just rip through the court. Oh, cheeky from Jodie Brown off the goalpost. Well, you hate that as a defender when that happens. Yeah, so I reckon it's a hangover of having a really tall shooter. Langman could always afford to rip through court. And if worse came to worse, you just pop the ball up.
That's right. Speaking of those cheeky little throw-ins, though, we've seen a couple already today. One, Juliana Naupu for Samoa, beautifully executed. One in the Samoa-Malawi game, not beautifully executed. Terribly embarrassing when you get it wrong. You've got to be, get the in and out of court thing right, don't you?
You do. It's all about your footwork.
Contact. Outside.
Shanette Bruce, really, everywhere.
Yeah, she's been good today.
Contact, goalkeeper, partial.
She's been good on the rebound, but she's also been really good in just covering that first move, and that's where the Ferns have come unstuck a couple of times. They've expected that easy pass into the shooter to be there, but Jeanette Bruce has just been standing in front and also had great footwork to cover it. That's better play from Langman. That's a sign of an experienced head. Just knew where it broke down before. Slow things down, look for a second option.
Well, 6 minutes gone in this quarter. Just one goal so far for Barbados. Nine in New Zealand. So perhaps a sign that they weren't at all happy with that third quarter.
Well, they had a great opening quarter. I think it was 9-2 at a similar point of the first quarter. And then really struggled in their openings in the second and third quarter. But this has been good. Just nice, sharp ball movement, preparedness to let the ball go. And defensively, they just picked things up from that third quarter.
Wing defender obstruction. That's it.
Went under brain. Started to figure it out.
Wing.
Yet another quandary for Waitamanu. Mez or Paseka? Or Tutaye at the back?
You don't often see her play at the back, and I think being at the back would really just almost just retard her movement because she really does love that space and that high entry into the circle. I reckon this last couple of quarters, though, sort of answered the question in my mind about where you play Laura Langman. I do like her at wing defence, but I've noticed her so much more at centre. Now, whether this game's got enough pressure in it to be definitive or not is a different story. But she's made a big difference in that position.
And we have an injury time halfway through the fourth quarter. Shaniqua Thomas. Certainly, I think the New Zealanders will be a lot happier with the situation in this stage of the game.
We asked about the difference between Paseka and Bailey Mears. Who do you go with? I think Paseka actually looks a bit more confident, really is demanding the ball a lot more on the shot. Very similar stats, 23 from 31 so far for Malia Paseka. Bailey Mears shot 24 from 31 in that first half. So few minutes to go in this game. Has Malia Paseka done enough? I suspect she has.
Now Barbados thinking, well, they won't be thinking about it now, I'm sure, but Australia lie ahead, as well as Trinidad and Tobago.
Sorry,
Well, New Zealand is keen to get on with it. What is Thomas Rather still on the floor? Faye Seely making her entrance to the game in this final quarter. So 7.5 minutes remaining, 66-25, New Zealand in charge. Again, Bruce.
Oh, she's hurt herself. She's looked proppy for about the last quarter and a half, Bruce, but she's just kept going.
Big margin in the corner there of your screen. 14-1 goals this corner. That's a telling stat. That's a very high pass. Can they get another Barbados?
Really great defensive work from Kataka and Debray. Just really good swapping, not allowing themselves to be set up through the movement of that Bayesian shooting circle. And you can hear the talk, you can hear Debray calling and calling the swap. She's such an experienced campaigner. And these sort of games are hard, Jen, defensively when you're sitting back at goalkeeper, because the ball doesn't come down to you a lot. And when it does, it doesn't come down with any sort of rhythm, because you know that your opposition are playing things so patiently and so carefully. They'd rather just throw short passes and really start to extend the ball. Makes it hard to read the play. And that's what the Silver Ferns defensive line really thrive on, being able to read the play and come out for those screaming defensive intercepts.
Once again, they have thwarted Barbados. Oh, what a ball from Rasmussen.
And what a take.
Contact outside.
So athletic.
Oh, that's a great shot from above. 68-26. See, 42 goals between these two.
Obstruction. Where you are.
Goal number three for the quarter.
Little set play there from the Silver Ferns, Jodie Brown and Grace Rasmussen on an overload, which means that the wing attack and the goal attack are on the same side of the court. Allows them to open up to the goal shooter on the opposite side. Didn't quite come off then. It is a nice little set play.
Debray putting the afterburners on to get back.
Well, she's had to do that a few times.
Oh, what a guard from Langman.
Do I reckon Laura Langman's better defensively when she's in centre as well?
Well, she's always described, isn't she, as a defensive centre.
Which makes you think that her wing defence roots really put her in as a strong wing defender, but I don't know, she just seems to have more space to be able to get to the ball when she plays centre.
Vantage obstruction goal attack.
Silver Ferns playing at will now.
Goal defence, contact. Let's flip a goal. Yeah. New Zealand. Goalkeeper, contact.
Seeing the pattern of play.
Vantage contact centre.
Jodie Brown just finding I guess, the reach of Paseka. It took them a little while to sort of get into that rhythm, but now they're into that rhythm. Brown's finding her really at will.
Paseka's third test.
Oh, what a yes!
Yes, go in! That's the play of the game. The crowd respond. Particularly those sectors.
Yeah, Jodie Brown will put that on her highlight reel.
Contact, goalkeeper.
That was
outside.
Awesome. Just a great
goalkeeper
pass to set it up.
Contact outside.
Shooters practice that, but they don't often get to do it in a game. And it looks great.
Yeah, she's got a very strong basketball background, Jodie Brown. Does the odd layup every now and then.
Certainly
brings the crowd alight. 72-27 into the final 2 minutes. Oh, good hands, Faye Seeley. So take a look at this.
No backboard. No backboard needed.
Oh, easy pickup for DeBrain.
Vantage contact.
Oh. Razzle dazzle from Rasmussen.
Goal line.
Good idea.
It didn't quite come off, but it looked promising.
Vantage contact, goal attack.
Just a great quarter from the fans. Have really responded well to the doldrums they found themselves in through the middle of this game, and the changes seem to have worked. It sparked them up 19-4.
Oh, Jeanette Bruce, rather, goalkeeper for Barbados. She'd have to be their player of the day. Never stop working at goalkeeper. And there she is again.
She's incredibly strong, isn't she?
Yeah, quite a veteran, 33. Been around. great to see the players enjoying themselves. She has had a good time out there. And why wouldn't you on the world stage? But New Zealand far too strong for Barbados in the end. 73-28.